Hey, there should be some audio disclaimer in front of these things. I'm totally against it, but go ahead. What are you saying now?
There should be some sort of audio disclaimer in front.
Like saying what? Like warning, don't have your children hear this.
No, 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 not like that. But just this is what happens when I leave the mics on. And
That kind of disclaimer? You want something to say like, okay, this isn't real. This is behind the scenes. We're just playing around.
It doesn't have to be that freaking involved, but yeah.
Can it just be this thing that I'm recording here now?
No.
This doesn't count as a thing. Because I haven't said go yet. This is just, as they say in the old days, floor tape.
Such a good song. And it is 100 bazillion percent an Elvis Costello ripoff.
Yeah.
Listen to this.
That I got, cause all the geeks that I meet, they all look cooler than me. But what to do when they're all looking at you? Cause you're the freak of the week, cause you're on the TV. Can you make me a promise? Stop it before we begin. Will you hold on to my hand if I ever lose it again?
Oh yeah, I had that CD for sure.
Now,
and only listen to track two.
Play this song back to back with Good Charlotte.
My phone
don't
can't
like
do that.
Boys, girls like cars and money. Wrong song. The girls don't like boys. I think it's called Boys and Girls.
Same producer or like different song? Same song.
No, it's just like it's the same. Like wait till it gets to the verse.
No, it just reminds me of like I was 20.
Yeah, it's the verse that's the same. Start from the beginning.
Spend a lot of all the clothes that I got. Can run the freak of the week.
Not such a rip.
And not my mix master AD.
Most conversations, but he'll put the villain.
Yeah, it's the exact same song.
Yeah.
Wow, thanks for the Good Charlotte. Said no whatever.
The guy who should
really
be thanking me. The guy who should be thanking me is Butch Walker from The Marvelous Three, who ripped off Elvis Costello to write that, where you can go like, hey, your Elvis Costello ripoff is the same as mine.
If Good Charlotte is before coffee, then the Apex Theory is after coffee, you know? Coffee and meth, probably. Here's that other one, though.
Yeah, this is a great song.
When this came out, I was like, oh, somebody ripped off Incubus. It's cool. But not like, Not like the...
Better than Geller bending silver spoons.
No, before that. This, like the science era. If you ever heard any of that stuff, it sounds like this, you know?
Some people have the tendency of sucking the life out of me. Try and fill me with forthcoming. Success is the way of the wise. Even when they are left alone, one has arrived.
I met this guy who came into the fishbowl on satellite without saying brand names and people. He came in and his hair was still silver. I guess it was really silver at that time, though. He's got a lot going on. He's still, like, relevant.
What's he doing?
I can't remember.
You know who did a great job at riding a one-hit wonder into, like, a real career is that Andrew WK guy.
Oh, yeah, the blood. That's, like, one of the most familiar record covers.
Yeah.
Because it's just
it really
bleeding.
Does speak to the power of an iconic image, like a good, like that's kind of like a legendary image. Like way more people know who he is from the picture than any of his music. It's like more people own a Ramones t-shirt than a Ramones album.
What was the one? Was it Party Hard?
Yeah, yeah. Well, he had like 10 songs on his album. Like 8 of them had the word party in them.
Yeah. Oh, man. Keyboards and everything.
Well, he was like a classically trained pianist, so he was the one playing the piano. Like, if he didn't play the piano, this wouldn't have had piano in it.
Oh, man, somebody right now is rocking out in their car. I can picture them now. And that person is probably me later.
You're right. This is up really loud. I was just about to say, it's me. Still making music exactly
really?
Like this. Oh, God, yeah. Keep getting worked on the records. Sevendust back in the day.
Oh. Dial 7 then.
Oh, that name rings a bell. But like we were supposed to tour with them and then like our guitar player got married and we're like, dick.
Yeah, thanks a lot, dude.
But great I mean timing. It wasn't gonna be that like I think we were gonna be the headliners, so that shows how big Sevendust were at the time. I remember walking up to like LeJean, the singer of Sevendust, once at a festival backstage, and I was just like, "Hey man," because we played some festival somewhere with him. I was like, "Hey man, good to meet you. My name's AD. I sing," and he was like, "Man, I know who you are." I was just like, "Oh, the guy from Sevendust knows who I am." Who's that?
That's Sevendust. That's like their that's enemy.
Oh, motherfucker, motherfucker, yeah! You know who,
They're hooker. Like, they're hook guys.
Out of all the, out of all these bands, the one that, had a song that I think I liked the most was, I thought it was interesting, and I thought they were going to be a really interesting band, and then they just weren't. was, do you remember that song, What a Day? Not a non-point,
what a
day.
Day, what a day. Mm-hmm.
Like really K-Rock good. In New York City played that, and I was like, damn. And then I saw them open some K-Rock thing up in there. I was like, that's a real deal band there.
Is it That Day?
No, it's called What a Day.
Oh, they did a cover of In the Air Tonight, I read.
Yeah, no, that was a big one that was used in like a million sporting things.
All day, thinking about your hangover in the bar, saying you left your fucking keys at night to beg for, ride from a stranger that I never met before. He acts so friendly that I had to take the ride, but for some reason he resembled that guy I wanted for a robbery and beating on his kids. You remind me of my stepson, he juggled with a grin.
Like, I really thought this band was going to be something. I was like, damn, this is, like, interesting. And then they weren't. Snot.
Mmm.
I love this album. I still listen to this album.
They're from where I'm from.
This album. So, like, you know how I said, like, the guy from Sevendust knew who I was?
Mm-hmm.
And that was kind of like, oh, that's kind of cool. Snot were actually really big fans of my band. Oh, Milhouse.
I really like Snot, that Milhouse. I mean, that's what I say inside when I hear Snot, too, is... All right, continue. You back?
Oh, yeah. No, they were just like, they were like really big fans of ours. Like, we met some, or at least some of them were. Like, there was this girl that used to follow me around, and she followed them around, too. Mm. And she was like, the fact that I know you got me onto their tour bus. I was like, really? And then, like, some buddies of mine at a record promotion company were just like, no, they're huge fans. We got to set up a tour. And I was like, so happy because this was like my favorite album, and then he died.
Yeah, the radio station I worked for, the news talk station up in Ventura, I mentioned that this band was one of my favorites. I think I was coming into the parking lot one day and playing it too loud. You know, the parking lot was under the building and there wasn't a lot of soundproofing, so I wanted to make sure the hip-hop station heard them. So, Bob from Dave and Bob, he's like 62 at the time. He goes, hey, what you listening to there? I go, oh, it's a band called Snot. You probably never heard of them. He's like, oh, yeah, Snot. Poor Lynn Strait, man. I'm like, what? He goes, yeah, I was a first responder. I was the press. I had to go out there and cover it.
Oh, wow.
So he told me, like, the, you know, the not-for-TV details.
You know,
like, man, you know, it shouldn't have happened. And you know what? There's so many deaths that happen in that very intersection, and it's still there because too many people are looking at the ocean while there's cross traffic.
Oh.
So people get creamed every year, at least.
You know,
and Bob thought that this would be big enough to get somebody to fucking put a traffic light or something there, but still it remains. Yeah.
So, like, Lynn from Snot was, Do you know he was in porn?
Oh, was he?
He was. There was.
Oh, that's not surprising. That's great.
There was a. There was like, so there's this band at the time called Society One. You ever hear them?
My balls, your jack.
No, Society One. You said
Society One, and I can't remember the name of the singer from Society One, but he was like a porn producer, and he threw like. He threw like bachelor parties for guys and bands and stuff, and the Society one would always open up for, you know, bands like Snot and Korn and stuff like that. So he came up with a porn series called Backstage Slut, where what they would do is, like, they would hear stories from the road, and like, they'd have, like, guys and bands telling road stories, and then porn actors reenact them.
Awesome.
Like, Fred Durst was in it, and, like, all these different guys. And then, like, one of the girls, I think, that was, you know, an actor in one of his movies had HIV, and all these guys and bands had had sex with her, so everyone was really scared for a second. But it was, like... It was crazy. And then Lynn was like, screw it, I'm not going to tell a story, I'm going to be in it. And so there was like this scene in a
that's awesome.
There's a scene in a porno where, like, it starts at a Snot concert, and then it's like Lynn's girlfriend and a groupie all go home together and have sex, and it's like, oh, that's the guy from Snot, and there's his junk. Okay. Like, it was weird.
All right, well, one more dead guy before we move on with this, okay? Because it is the El Día de los Muertos. Well,
is
yeah,
it?
I do.
But I never knew what that was.
That means the Day of the Dead. El Día
well, I know
de
that,
los
but
Muertos.
I don't know what the Day of the Dead is.
It was November 1st, I think, is the day, actually. Guess what my first interview was here. Oh, this is Society One.
Oh, okay, like, I wasn't familiar with their music, but they sound like all that stuff, right?
Yeah, this was my very first interview ever. I was like 16 years old. So, Mr. Static, how did you start a band? Well, there's a picture of it somewhere.
We had, we had the same management for a while, so we'd like go to parties and these guys would be there. And he's like such a quiet guy.
Yep.
You'd never know it was him because he had his hair down. Brad Michael.
Yeah, he was such a good guy. Because he was my first interview, I followed his career a little closer than I would anyone else. And
yeah.
It was devastation.
Do you remember, like, this band kind of had an ugly history. Do you remember they had a Japanese guy playing guitar in the band, and then they got rid of the Japanese guy? This all happened, you know, it was online, but it all happened before, like, shit spread like wildfire over the internet. But like, so Static X had a Japanese guitar player who quit or got fired or whatever, and they replaced him with, I think, a guitar player that used to play in that band Dope. Do you remember Dope?
Oh yeah, underrated.
So I think it was a guitar player from Dope, and then they had a they
it's hard to talk under Wayne Static, isn't it?
I'm just trying to remember the circumstances of it. No, you know what it was?
Mm.
They found him and a 14-year-old girl asleep in his car. And what he'd been doing, he had been going online on, like, dating sites or, like, some sort of, like, gothy social networking site and meeting underage girls.
Sure, at the time?
Yeah, yeah, or, like... He'd been meeting underage girls online, pretending to be like, I'm a lookalike of the guy from Dope. Like, I'm not actually the guy from Dope.
How creative.
Yeah.
It seemed to have worked. I like to fall asleep in cars with girls.
Yeah, and like, so like, underage sex, he got kicked out of the band super quick, and all of a sudden the Japanese guy was back in, and there was no mention of it. You know who else has a really jacked up history?
Mm.
The drummer from Cake was sent to jail for molesting a 3-year-old.
Oh.
Yeah.
He's a loser. He's a loser. There was a guy I was supposed to play in a band. It was supposed to play a holiday festival, Chill on the Hill. It was a big roster. Like, it's the winter show. I think The Offspring was even there, too. I can't remember the name of the band, but like the week before, he got in trouble for being with somebody underage.
You were telling me this story. It was
files charged on their.
I'm so addicted to all the things you do.
That fucking bad.
Can't remember.
Saving Abel.
I'm so addicted to all the things you do.
So we spent 3 months saying, "Hey, come see this band. It's gonna be great, awesome. They're great guys." And they, phone interviews up leading up to it, and they're like, "Yeah, we know how to snowboard." You know, and then a week like. This is the week to win. Get on the bus. You know, it was a big deal because we had Bonanza Beverage involved. Bunch of fucking money. And then the fucking news comes out. Popular Vegas radio station's leading band in their holiday concert has been found guilty of diddling children. And I'm like, oh, no. So now I have to sit there and go, so they're still going to play, but just not that guy. Because the... there was so much tied into it that they wouldn't bail on the band, that they just, I guess, dumped the guy. And then these guys were scheduled to play all the way up to, like, the last day. And, of course, they didn't show up. But we didn't know they weren't going to show up. Everyone was stupid enough to believe they were on the way, you know. But that's a press nightmare, and you're never going to play again. But I guess they did. It's hard to fight a story in the news that isn't yours, but you get hit by it. It's a good song, though, I guess. It's not like you to turn away. All the bullshit I can't say. Just when I think I can walk away. Well, that'll sober you up pretty quick if some dude is like, "What? So what? She was 17, man. Come on, you saw how hot she was. Come on."
It is kind of a weird thing, though. Like, it is a weird thing, though, because, like, when you go to different countries, the age is different. You know, it's just like it goes from, like, "You pig, she was, you know, not 18 yet," to, you know, 17. The legal age is 16. It's very strange.
"And we are 12. It is okay with us. We have a population downfall from coldest to war. So I'm working on my SAG card. I have two more points." Oh, hold on a second.
Oh,
so anyway, I have my degree in journalism, but I really want to get into the dramatic arts. Oh, here comes another. How is this still on the global top 50?
Children.
The club isn't the best place to find a lover, so the bar is where I go.
You know, it's weird. He makes all these records with, like, you know, full produced things and everything, but whenever he plays live, it's just him and an acoustic guitar. Like, even when he's playing stadiums, like, it's
easier that way.
That way. But I mean, I can't believe
the smartest guy in show business. Well, I brought my guitar here. I'm going to play some songs for you. Okay, goodbye then.
Yeah. Thank you for my $20 million.
Waiting here for someone.
Oh, yeah. Niall Horan.
Oh, jeez.
One Direction.
All over the iHeart.
Oh, was he? I got to meet him, talked to him for about 7 minutes. Now I'm waiting here. He feels most comfortable with his guitar, and it was too far to reach during the interview. Love, do you feel this rough? Why is it he brought his own microphone, too. It's probably this one here that he's singing into.
Shadows dance without you for the first time. My heart is open.
I mean, we're going back into the easy listening 70s, and I'm fine with that.
Yeah, it's fucking Dan Fogelberg. And I only found out who Dan Fogelberg was because he got mentioned in a Dennis Leary stand-up sketch where he's like, "Thanks to Dan Fogelberg, I didn't get a blowjob until I was 27 years old.
Yep.